Hello world and welcome back to another video. This time we are coming at you from New Zealand and we're starting out on the North Island of New Zealand. But before we get into that too far, I just wanted to give a shout out to our new hair and makeup consultant. After some comments on the last video, it felt like we had to make a change, and so I contacted Felix Hair Design in Burnt Hills. Scott Felix runs Felix Hair Design, and if you've ever seen Scott's hair, you know it's on point. So I knew that it was going to be a good choice and would really let me take my appearance further. So thanks to Scott Felix for all his help. All right, well, let's get started. Our trip to New Zealand would not be complete without talking about the camper van. So it was a challenge at times, but very fun. But I'm not going to talk any more about the camper van because Sabine does such a wonderful job in this next clip introducing the camper van and telling us all about it. So check it out. Here's Sabine.
Hello and welcome to the camper van. This is what we've been living in New Zealand for the past about a month. It has a lot of great features, but it's also very small. Welcome inside. The kitchen, it's got a refrigerator that locks because some bumpy rides. The stove is a two flame, and then it's got some cabinets over here where we keep the pots and pans. This is the microwave. This is where we keep our jackets and some of the lunch bags and the dinner bags. All the cabinets have a special lock on them so that they don't open when we drive. This table is what we eat on, and it makes a couch for me and Siri to rest our legs on so that we don't have to get it in and out every day. This is the bed. We keep these two bins up here so that they're not in the way down here. It goes up and down pretty much two times a day. We keep the covers and blankets, pillows, all that up there. This is the porta potty to make it self-contained. We have never used it, but at least it's there. So this is some of the compartments where we keep our stuff. That's my parents' stuff, and this is me and Siri's stuff. We keep our bags under here, under the seat, so that they're out of the way. These curtains go out and in to make it dark when Sawyer is currently taking a nap. These are Christmas decorations. We set up the paper chain pretty much the start of the trip, and then the Christmas tree came a little later, so we bought some ornaments and cut the tinsel from that tinsel. Oh, we even got the star on top. Yeah. And then we have some more stuff that we keep up there. So there's trucks, some people's shoes. And then Mom, Dad, and Sawyer sit up here. That's the camper van. How's that?
That's awesome.
After arriving in Auckland, we headed north to Paihia. That's pretty far up the North Island. Paihia is famous for the Waitangi Treaty Grounds, and this is where the Maori signed a treaty with the British. And so it's a bit of an important place in New Zealand culture and in Maori history. So we did go up there. And also, in addition to checking out the Waitangi Treaty Grounds, we also happened upon this cool little adventure center where the girls did some trapeze work.
Thank you.
After Pythia, we began to head south along the west coast, and one of our first stops was in a kauri forest to see Tane Mahuta. Tane Mahuta is an enormous kauri tree, one of just very few of these super large trees left. Most of them were cut down, and so it was pretty special to be able to see this tree, estimated to be about 2,500 years old. And then following that, we had a long time on some typical New Zealand highways, windy, narrow, and winding trees. South to make our way toward the Coromandel Peninsula. We went to the Hot Water Beach, and Hot Water Beach is hot because there is some geothermal activity pretty close to the surface, and at low tide you can actually dig yourself your own little hot tub. We happened to be there at high tide, bad luck of course, but it was still fun. You could dig your toes down into the sand and feel how hot it was. And then we also went to a cool little spot called Cook's Beach, and then onto Cathedral Cove. Just a gorgeous seaside set of caves and coves and pass-throughs, cliffs. So really beautiful scenery out there on the Coromandel Peninsula. After our time in the Coromandel Peninsula, we went to the town of Rotorua. Rotorua is mostly popular for two things, and one, it's seen as the seat of Maori culture from New Zealand, and also a lot of geothermal activity there. But before we checked out those biggies, we went to the Redwoods Tree Walk. This is a really special place. There's this grove of 115 or so year old redwood trees, and they have carefully suspended a number of platforms and bridges using some special slings so the trees aren't really hurt or drilled into. And you can go up and be up there in the canopy and walk through these majestic redwoods. It's really a cool spot to check out in Rotorua. Also in Rotorua, we went to the Waiutapu geothermal area, and this is a spot where you can see a very predictable geyser, and also there's a number of other hot pools, hot springs, mineral springs, boiling lakes, mud pools. Also in Rotorua, Erica and the girls went zip lining and found a great spot to go do that. Unfortunately, the footage was lost from the zip lining. I'm always very, very careful with the footage and keep it all in triplicate, but somehow late at night, I made a mistake and deleted the files. And so in the files were recovered, but a lot of quality was lost in the recovery. So they're here, but not in our typical good 4K quality.
Is attached.
That was awesome.
Yeah. Are their hands off? Okay, hands off now. 3, 2, 1. You're gonna cannonball for me. Bring your knees up, okay? Real high. Okay, knees up. right, you can go. Okay. Take your feet up. Woo-hoo! Woo! Turn around and face me. Beautiful. One step, two step. Okay, throw your head back and bring your feet up.
After our time in Rotorua, we headed further south to Wellington, and Wellington is where you catch the ferry to go over to the South Island. So the two islands are close, but it's a couple hours on the ferry in order to get down to the South Island. They've got a great system here, the ferry's good, people are friendly, and you load your camper van right on the ferry and set off. And so this brings us to the end of our time in the North Island. So when we see you again, we'll be in the South Island. Bye-bye.